Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome. And for those to whom it applies, Happy Mother's Day. Let me share that, everybody.
Happy Mother's Day.
I do have a couple of announcements to make. One is to welcome back Gretchen Burdick, our music minister of music for our church. It's been quite a while. We're glad you're back with us. And why don't we give her a hand for being here? And another thing, as reminded, we now have Wi-Fi here. So if your phone is on, please put it on airplane mode, your iPad or whatever, and won't get in the way of the service today. So we appreciate that. We are doing Bible study on Wednesdays from 6 o'clock to 7 o'clock on blue jeans. If you would like to be part of this, just send an email to the church and we'll get to you how you get on the blue jeans. And we're studying the book of Acts. So it's been kind of interesting because at this time of year, we're also in the book of Acts. So it's kind of interesting. Let me keep that flowing that way. Is there anything else that should come before us this morning as a matter of joy or concern? Well, let us begin our worship with our call to worship. Come, all who are born of God.
We abide in the love revealed in Jesus Christ.
Celebrate God's steadfast love and faithfulness.
We gather in response to the one who calls us friends.
Let your hands share and your voices echo God's love.
We live by the faith that may conquer the world.
It is in this spirit that we gather to worship as a people of God. Let us pray together our invocation. Come, Holy Spirit, lift us from the warm routines to your surprising joy and to your love. Open our hearts to trust your leading through days of difficulty and nights of despair. Calm our doubts and guide us through the grip of fear. You have called us together for mutual support. We remember that we have been loved by our mothers, whose love for us reflected the love you have shown us in Jesus Christ. Teach us to follow where the risen Christ leads. Amen. And this morning, Linda West will be doing our scripture reading.
This morning's scripture is from the first letter of John, chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is a child of God. And everyone who loves the Father loves his children too. We know we love God's children if we love God and obey his commandments. Loving God means keeping his commandments. And really, that isn't difficult. For every child of God defeats this evil world by trusting Christ to give the glory. And the ones who win this battle against the world are the ones who believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And Jesus Christ was revealed as God's Son by his baptism in water and by shedding his blood on the cross. Not by water only, but by water and blood. And the Spirit also gives us the testimony that this is true. Here ends the scripture.
Thank you.
I know I don't have to tell you this, today's Mother's Day, and hopefully this is no new news to you. In this church, we honor our mothers, living and dead, by purchasing the blankets in their honor or their memory. Blankets for which the Church World Service will find creative uses all over the world. On Mother's Day, we remember what our maternal relatives taught us. How often do you hear a maternal voice in your head? The same voice you heard at the breakfast table, in the garden, in the living room, in the car, at church? Our mothers taught us a whole lot about living, didn't they? Mom taught us to appreciate a job well done when she said, "If you're going to kill each other, do it outside. I just finished cleaning." Mom taught us religion when she said, "You better pray that comes out of the carpet." She taught us how to time travel when she said, "If you don't straighten out, I'm going to knock you to the next week." She taught us logic when she said, "Because I said so, that's why." She taught us osmosis when she said, "Shut your mouth and eat your food." She taught us contortionism when she said, "When you look at the back of your neck, it's really dirty." She's taught us stamina when she said, "Will you sit there until all the broccoli is gone from your plate?" From personal experience, I know the family dog does not like broccoli. She taught us anticipation when she said, "Just wait until your father gets home." She taught us wisdom when she said, "When you get to be my age, you will understand." And now we do understand, don't we? More seriously, let's just take a moment and think about the things your mother taught you, the things that helped you get to this point in your life, the things you still hear in that maternal voice in your head. Just take a minute or two and think about that. Why do you think she taught you all those things? Did she do it just to lord over you? Or was she worried about you? Or was it because she loved you? I hope it was because she loved and loves you. Is there anything stronger than a mother's bond with her children? I don't think so. I don't think even Gorilla Glue measures up to the bond. This is the love that we celebrate today. The epistle writer John focuses his first letter on God's love, the love that elicits our love, in the passage that Linda West just read. John is winding up his letter as he writes, "Everyone who believes in Jesus as the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child." John discerns that every one of us, every human being, is a member of God's large and loving family. At the heart of this family are many of the things our mothers taught us. And you look at it, feel about it. God loves us with a mother's love. This is not always a warm and fuzzy love. It's sometimes a tough love. It's a love that can pin your ears back, and a love that wraps us up in a comforter. It's a love that understands us and appreciates us and anticipates us. It is a love that forgives us and leads us. Yes, God loves us like a mother, and is in many ways that mothering voice that we hear inside our heads. And God's love is as strong and persistent as a mother's Gorilla Glue bond. So today, let us all celebrate what our mothers taught us and what God's motherly love still teaches us. Amen. Let us pray. O God, our loving parent, we are grateful for the women in our lives, those who brought us into life, who taught us right from wrong, and who helped us to learn the basic skills we needed to succeed in life. We have been blessed by the women who made your love tangible for us. For many of us, these were our birth mothers. For others, they were our grandmothers, aunts, or stepmothers who adopted us, stepping in when they saw a need. They shaped us into the people we are today. We celebrate this day knowing that it is not a day of joy for everyone. We ask your blessing on those who yearn to be a mother despite physical challenges. We ask your blessing on those who are caring for an ailing mother or grandmother. We ask for your comfort and compassion for those who have recently lost their mother, or for those mothers who have lost a child. Enfold them all in your maternal embrace, O God, and comfort them in their time of sorrow. Encourage and empower the mothers who are raising and providing for their children on their own. Bring reconciliation to the mothers and children when their relationships are broken and in tatters. Create the space in mother and child for understanding, for forgiveness, for healing. And now, O God, be in our personal prayers as we pray them in the quiet of this moment. O God, we give you our thanks that you are like a mother with us as we are embraced in your abiding love, the love we know because of Jesus Christ, who taught us this prayer saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Go now from your pew, your chair, your couch, knowing that God has a mother's heart that loves, that guides, that chastises, that forgives, and enables you to go about the living of your life very well. Thanks be to God.